Hi friends, Mike Smith here, Senior Minister of Minchinbury Anglican Church. It's Friday, which means it's church news time. Well, Easter is just around the corner. Palm Sunday is this coming Sunday, and I have some good news to share. Of course, at Palm Sunday, it's a great time of the year anyway, as we remember the triumphal entry of Jesus into Jerusalem. But this Sunday, we have an even greater reason to rejoice, because you may have heard during the week that our government announced some easing of restrictions with respect to places of worship. From next Monday, we can sing together unmasked, which is wonderful. But even better than that is our Archbishop, in the last couple of days, his last week of work for the Diocese of Sydney before he retires today, he managed to negotiate with the Health Minister of New South Wales to get an exemption for our churches for this weekend, which means that this Sunday, Palm Sunday, we can sing together unmasked, and we don't need to revert back to the 4 metre squared capacity rule, which is an absolute blessing. So can I encourage you, come and sing and celebrate with us this Palm Sunday, 10 a.m. or 6 p.m. I'm going to be preaching on Jesus riding into Jerusalem, and we're going to, I guess, push away those clouds that so often blur people's vision of Jesus. We're going to see him for who he really is and what our response to him ought to be as we approach Easter for another year. That's Palm Sunday, this Sunday. Make sure you book your seats using the links in the description box below. And then this Easter week, let me tell you what is happening. Good Friday, next Friday, 9:30 a.m. here in the church. We're having a reflective service for all ages, the whole family. There'll be something for the kids. There'll be morning tea with hot cross buns after the service. But the service itself will be a reflective service. We're going to share together in the Lord's Supper as we remember the great sacrifice that Jesus made for us and indeed the whole world. Good Friday, 9:30. Use the links below to make sure you book your seat for that service. And then on Easter Sunday, we have our normal two Sunday services at this moment. We'll have a 10 a.m. celebration service for the whole family, something for the kids. In fact, there's going to be kids' activities, Easter activities, after the service, 10 a.m., and then we have our regular night service, and that'll be a wonderful, joyous celebration of the resurrection of our Lord Jesus. So make sure you book your seats for our Easter services using the links below. Good Friday, 9:30, Easter Sunday, 10 a.m. and 6 p.m. We will continue to live stream the morning services on Good Friday and Easter Sunday for those that can't make it. But can I encourage you, given we can now sing together, take this opportunity to gather together with God's people and celebrate the victory that Jesus has won over sin, death, and the devil this Easter. Now, after Easter, we have another exciting event that I would really commend to you and particularly encourage you to think about, to pray, and invite someone to attend. And that is, I'm going to be running, after the school holidays, the One Life Christianity Explored course. It's a 6-week course exploring life, faith, meaning, and how Jesus fits into all of that. So can I encourage you, from the 26th of April, 6 Monday nights, explore the person and work of Jesus. Pray and think about who you could invite and come along with to support them in their own exploration of Christianity and the person of Jesus. People do become followers of Jesus as a result of doing this course. So it's a wonderful opportunity. Can I commend it to you? Pray, invite, and support that course. Well, friends, that's all the news for today. Looking forward to this weekend, singing, rejoicing, praising God for who he is and what he has done for us. God bless. We'll see you soon.